I'm really excited about what we're hearing from our panel presenters. We've been having lots of conversations with people over the last almost 2 years, and the timing has been right. The incentives have been right because of people's values and their interest and the reality they experience themselves and with family members and people who are their friends and neighbors. Despite what Rick has said, we don't want to legislate and require visible housing. We want it to be required to the extent where it's clear what's needed, and to have policy and incentives and practices that will encourage and enable. The complexity of building homes is way beyond my ken, and the reality of what it takes to manage a whole city, let alone the diversity of resources and amenities that we need to support every potential reality of people's lives, is very, very complex. That's why every stakeholder group has their role. And I think it's really important. I'm going to take a couple of minutes, if I can continue to talk here, and talk about some of the policy things that we've experienced and directions that we're hoping to be able to have continue. Next slide, Lindsay. So first of all, with the building code, right now there is a change to harmonize with the Accessibility for Ontarians with Disabilities Act, and to have more inclusive communities. There is a requirement for accessible features, barrier-free features that meet the visible requirements in any new building with 3 or more floors, which is wonderful. The task group has asked the building code to increase the requirement for other kinds of types, townhouses, row houses, duplexes, to start to introduce that into the lexicon and to encourage things to happen on a more regular basis. The Ontario's growth plan that Tanya talked about is a wonderful plan with a key direction to increase density in certain urban areas, ours included, which is great. We also have the Ontarians with Disabilities Act, Accessibility for Ontarians with Disability Act, and standards that don't apply to housing, but the interest in being fully inclusive and accessible could potentially be in conflict with the interest to be have greater intensification and greater density. Because the challenge, as we learned it through our research, is that no step entrance is that it is the most difficult thing to do if you have a small footprint for your lot. A lot easier with the larger. Not impossible at all, but it can be a disincentive. So we need to be aware that our visions at the highest level play themselves out consistently and well, so you don't inadvertently block or discourage some really important innovations. The federal, provincial, and regional governments all play a role in affordable housing with funding and with dispersing the funding. We have asked the region and we've asked the province to require that any affordable housing built with government dollars be required to be visible to meet that standard, which is a reasonable request given that the population of people who tend to need long-term affordable housing will have other kinds of challenges and are a population that has a higher need for visible features. And it's important everywhere, but this is an area where there can be an expectation that increases the stock that we have. At our local level, next one. Now, all of the official plans in Waterloo Region have language that encourages accessibility, housing for seniors to varying degrees. Some, like the City of Cambridge, actually state that they could require certain proportions to have accessibility. So the language is there, but the reality is it doesn't necessarily play itself out and translate itself into more housing that's being built with these features. We have found that there's technical guidelines, and it would be really, really helpful, and we've asked the municipalities, the cities in particular, to develop technical guidelines so that builders and people who are wanting homes to be built can be better educated about some of the technical and design realities of some of these features, particularly the no-step entrance. Zoning bylaws, they totally mystify me, but they are important to translate the official plan. Right now, the three cities in the region are reviewing their zoning bylaws, and I hope that they will find more harmonization between the municipalities and also look for those elements that either need to be clearly stated, there can be exceptions, or that actually have flexibility for any possible situation that might arise with visible features. Things like setback, lot width requirements, drainage, all of those need to be consistent and supportive. And we've asked that all site and development plan submissions, we haven't made this direct request, but we're noticing that there isn't necessarily a great connection between the submission of a proposal and the policy. Somehow we have to have every player along the way to be fully informed and educated, like we see is happening very consistently in the city of Waterloo, so that when a site plan or development plan comes in for housing or for a complex, that it's clearly stated to be visible and is recognized, and that can trigger at least a greater awareness of some of the areas where they might need to give careful attention. So in terms of that, we just wanted to say that policies are important, practices are important, and the practices of real estate professionals and of builders is really on their own incentive, which is really, really important. So again, I reiterate, there isn't a stakeholder group that doesn't have an important role to play. All right, I think I'm done. I would pass this on to Sydney, but I think she's getting her lunch ready. So I'm gonna pretend to be the MC again, if you bear with me. I wanna thank all of the panel members, myself included. That was tremendous. Oh, wait a minute, no, we're not ready to wrap up. I have to say thank you, Trudy. That was really good. And then I will moderate the question and answer. And if you have questions of me, be gentle. But right now, I'd like to open up. And if you have any questions of the panel, and I might need to, can you do the runner?
Oh,
we're not videotaping this. Yes.